Hi people, Punky here, welcome back to this channel. In this episode we're doing a review for tier 3 Russian medium premium tank T-29. So after T-28 coming T-29, not in this game but in real life, yes. So that is why we had review for T-29, 8 and now for T-29, okay. So we'll do this review from two main parts, this short in garage part, then three fantastic games, you know, one mine, one random live game, and one of your best games in this tank. So let's start with appearance of this tank, you know. It is a huge target, a wide too, you know, it is not easy with this tank, and it is ugly as crap. And like we said, this is, you know, evolution of T-28, at least it was in real life. So let's compare it actually with, well, even T-28, which is much more beautiful. But let's compare it with a benchmark for size on this channel, my red T-34. So like you can see, T-29 is huge tank. It looks like heavy tank, you know. And it is hard to hide this tank, especially because it has bad gun depression. So you need to expose more of your tank if you're going behind some slope. So what about a gun on this tank? Well, it is a howitzer gun, you know, it is pretty damn good for this kind of gun. Here it is, you have 110 average penetration with AP rounds and heat gold rounds. With AP rounds that I recommending, you have 164, not 184. So I was doing, you know, you will see in gameplay later, more than average actually. So penetration is 66 with AP rounds, 75 with heat rounds, and 38 with HE rounds that I recommending for this gun. But do carry all of them, you know. Rate of fire 12.8, accuracy very bad, 0.55 more, which is you know, bad. Aiming time 2.3 seconds, not bad. It is standard for medium tanks, so not bad at all. So a gun is good, just you know, it has bad accuracy and bad gun depression. So what about armor on this tank? Okay, here we have armor of T-29, and best armor is here and here, 30 millimeters, but that is not actually toughest armor. Here toughest armor is actually this truck, which can be very hard to pen even for some tier 6 and tier 7 tanks. So avoid shooting in trucks, because even angled like this, you need something like up to 67 millimeters of penetration to pen that. And also avoid gun mounted because that is rough. Because this armor is weak, but it has some sloped edges, you know, some auto guns will bounce on those edges more. So what about driving of this tank? Okay, driving of this tank is easy. It is decently fast, you know, 44.6 forward top speed, 20 in reverse. That is pretty good for this big tank. And traverse speed is also very good, both on your hull and very, very solid on your turret too. So in combination, you know, you will be able to, you know, follow with your aim those tanks and not allow them to overflank you or something. So how you should use it? It is like almost heavy tank of tier 3, you know, so you should use it more or less like that, but not always. If you are in tier 4 game, then you should maybe take second line, sometimes even third line, and try to, yeah, when I say snipe with a howitzer gun, it sounds silly, but try to hit those targets from distance. So like you can see, we carry gun length drive for even faster aiming, and improved ventilation, because we have just two slots on these tier 3 tanks. And here we have a small repair kit and small med. I carry 30 rounds of HE, 30 rounds of AP, and 7 rounds of gold heat, which I usually don't fire, you know. So my crew is here. Like you can see, I researching camo for this tank. And I have, of course, 6 sense for commander, designated target for gunner, and smooth ride for your driver, for first lady operator call for vengeance, and for second one situational awareness, because you have that increased UV range. So that is that for in garage part. Let's see that awesome gameplay now, and we will start with my first game. Okay, so our first game here on Westfield, it was tier 4 match like you can see, but can this tank do well in tier 4? Let's see that also. So yeah, I calling this tank wannabe KV2, you know. Turret is kind of similar, you know, it has the gun, but it is faster and longer. Let's see what that M5 you are doing, for love's sake. Just because of people like this, I'm glad they... discarded friendly damage, to say like that. I couldn't find what that was. They removed friendly damage, yes. That is that. But who knows, maybe he would be banned right now. So I'm searching for targets, no targets. That BT-7 just spotted all the tanks and died. It was just before they moved the BT-7 in tier 4. So more or less everything else is the same. And let's see. So we fighting for gun depression. There is no gun depression on this turret either, which is kind of strange because it is huge turret, like you can see, very tall tank, and having just this much gun depression is a little bit strange. But wow, that was full damage there. Though that was hit too. Though we didn't do full damage, you know. I was, you know, robbed there a little bit, because, like I said, full damage is 184, and we did 183, so that is one hit point less, you know. Okay, another tank going in, washer doing fantastic job spotting there, you know. And there is Yellow Canary in his Bison artillery behind us. All the way on that edge, you know. And that T-46 didn't learn from all that tanks being shot there why they keep going forward. I was aiming on Panzer TJ destroying T-28. I will take that, you know. Panzer 38 NA destroy 2. And that is just lovely jubbly job, you know. Having things like this, you know, sorted is very good. Though this tank can, you know, do punch in maps that are more closed, you know. Maybe it is even better for those maps if you have something to cover your hull, you know. If you don't have, well, it is wide, big body, you know. Something will bounce, but you know, you are big target too. So let's show you that, you know, we are going down, we are going down, and any moment now, yep, we are spotted. So that dude going up, we shoot one in move, that was lucky shot, and I just thinking he doesn't have a gun depression. Maybe I was wrong, but I too dare too far, you know. I don't have anything big to lose there. And now they're going up. Stuk 3B that could, you know, shoot me is all over there, and we did the 64 to him, you know. But damage is damage, and this gun can shoot fast, like you can see. So it is one of those dirt guns that is a fast firing gun, like on BT-7, like on Matilda and some other things. Okay, that dude destroyed two and just two artillery left now. Can we take some extra damage here? Let's see, like you can see, tank is pretty mobile. It is very mobile and the only problem is size and gun depression, you know. So even like this, this is a formidable opponent, you know, if you meet it in tier 3, so you need to be extra careful not to be dead. Not only because he can take big chunk out of you, but because he can in same time de-chuck you, damage your models or engine, you know, or kill your entire crew with one shot if you have tiny tank and small crew next to each other, you know. So that was that, actually. A very fast game. Let's just see that victory sign. There is no victory sign. Okay, so this was our number 3 M badge in this tank. 17,000 credits on 29 shots fired, 15 on target. Okay, not bad, you know. 8 tanks damage and we killed 2. Team score, set on experience. We are actually second in experience right after washer dryer, 2 kills, second in that 2, well, third after this one, and 1017 HP of damage first in that personal score. We even spotted that artillery, got high caliber Confederate, Levasseur medal, we cannot pronounce that, far for effect, bruiser and M badge for this tank and this game. So now let's see one live game. Okay, so now it is time for one live game in T29. So let's see, it is EU1 server. Finally I got EU1 server from first, you know, I don't need to switch, and it is okay map, you know. Kills, mines, rooting, I don't know how you're calling this map, but it is perfect and it is bad MM. It is tier 4. But we have dub gun, you know. We'll do at least some damage, hopefully. And we are on the wrong side for this kind of tank, you know. Especially when there is artillery in game. So what that means actually, here is my camo, okay. I was searching for this camo. So what that means is that we will be forced to, you know, instead to just shoot from distance. We don't want to be engaged in this big target from up close, because you know, it is huge target. They can do easy damage to us. There you go, M15 went in that seat position. Ooh, there is enemy. There is enemy T-29 who just jumped there and nobody paying attention on that dude for some reason. Ooh, that was nice damage. Ooh, that is even better. Is he even realizing what is going on here? Okay, that is even better. Ooh, that is better. Ooh, I hit something in front of him, I think. That would be the tracking shot. I think that was hit too. Ooh, that was miss actually. As it was obvious. Okay. So we still have targets there, I think. Yeah, I think that was hit. I think those run hitting, you know. Oh, there you go. Explosion. I'm not sure if we have 6 cents on this. I think not yet. So where is that Swedish soul? Oh, that is still 4 Tengisor with a punchy little gun. Okay, we will just shoot a little bit more there. Oh, I carry 30 rounds of AP. Is it possible that I don't see splash from here, there, or I hitting really something? Oh, for Lord's sake. Ooh, he aiming straight into me. Did you saw that? Straight into me, like he knew I was here. You know. But I do have 6 cents, so that is cool to know. You know. And now he is roasted. He is roasted. Let's find that sweet angle of elevation. Oof! How he dodged that. Good job, good job. Good job. He was aiming here because he knew I was shooting at him from there, you know, before, previously. Oh! Okay, out of luckers here. Out of luckers, I don't know why they are attacking when they are losing, actually. Okay, I think this will be full penetration. Okay, one more time. Oh, my ammo. That dude is dead. That dude is dead. Okay. So now we just have this Swedish soul, but he can one-shot me, I think, with that gun. I want to be careful, you know. Probably waiting just there in that bush for me. Mm-hmm. Oh, he wants platoon. Okay, let's do it. Okay, that is it. Oh, that was just critical. Okay, that was better. And that was the end of him, you know. But so not bad. Even this AP runs can be handy in the end, you know. But H runs are, you know, number one priority, to be like an Irish. Okay, speaking Serbian a little bit. Okay, so what we have left here to see post-game data and then your best game in this tank. And that should be lovely jubbly. Okay, just first class mastery badge, you know. And we got something, okay. We didn't play this tank for a long time, you know. So we got that patch, and we were okay, first in experience, second in damage in both teams. That is good, and we earn 18,000 credits. So if you need tank to earn what the hell is this, to earn money, not to learn money. To earn money, then this wannabe KV2 is pretty good thing, you know, to start. So what is this crew? It is crew just for T-29, you know. I started from zero, I remember now. But I mean, I started from 100%, so I can probably retrain this screw for something else, maybe my T-150. But time for your best game in this tank. Hi people, Punky here, welcome back to this channel. I mean, this is your best game in this tank, yeah, here on every map. Or Manasi map, sorry. I'm so used to stuff like that, you know, with so this player really likes his T-29, you know. He has a lot of badges. I have them too, you know, but I cannot put them on because usually I carry those gift and reward camos, and for some reason I cannot put this on them. So maybe I don't know how. Maybe they changed that. I don't know. I know on some you can. For example, on that black that I really like, on that one you can. Probably they change for rest of them, so you would pay, you know, for buying real camo, you know. Because they noticed, you know, you can interchange those gift and reward camos, and then people stop, I guess, buying camouflages. And now they introduce these stickers, so you cannot put stickers on every of those. So they basically force you to play without those camos, or to, I don't know why he moved from that cover, or to buy camo, you know, on which you can put it. Okay, that is enemy T-29, and he's finally dead. He was rushing, shooting, blah blah, not very good. But I guess our friend should stay just there. I would stay there behind that tank and shoot at them. On other hand, who knows? Oh, look at that, you know, turret of that BT tank, BT5. Okay, he was expecting, you know, his hull to see, but hull is behind his dead tank. So that was nice play, you know. this is some weird crap. It looks like artillery or something now. So he has skills, obviously. That was shot from something else. Chihi, Chiha. Okay, Chiha.
Chiha!
Bless you. So let's see. You have speed, you have maneuverability, you have a gun, like I said, just gun depression, and huge size is what is bad about this tank. But sometimes big huge size can be, you know, your benefit also. Because you can shoot over some obstacles that low pitcher tanks cannot use. Oh, that is BT-7 hot, I wouldn't stay there. But he didn't saw him, you know. He was spotted, but our friend, you know, went unspotted, and that was one good clutch shot there. A little bit of luck. Two and three tank left. Three tank left. Okay, there is one of them. BT-10 hot. Panzer 3 is shooting at him, and he doesn't even paying attention until now on that thing. Nice damage on Panzer again. And that should be kill. Yes, that is kill. BT-7 is trying. Struggle with gun depression, you saw that. And again, weird lucky shot there. And now artillery is just his. you know, and ooh, that went below that part of turret, you know. Yes, that artillery has turret. So that was 7 kills for, we didn't even say the name, Tommy3112. Very nice, quick game out of kills. And let's see what he did in, you know, garage, in post-game data, and then... Okay, so Tommy earned 61,000 credits in this tank, 29 shots fired, 28 on target, perfect accuracy there. And let's see, he damaged 9 and killed 7 tanks. Team score set on experience, so 1,796 stars of experience. Is this some sort of glitch, mistake? I don't know, but it looks a little bit impossible for what he did here. Anyway, 7 kills for him and 2,642 HP of damage. By far better than anyone else in both teams in all three of those. Let's see, he even spotted 2 enemy tanks, got top gun, high caliber, far for effect duelist, demolition expert, bruiser, and M badge for this tank and this game. So okay, now let's see that last section and what I think, should you keep this tank or sell it for 1 free slot? And in the end, that question, should you keep this tank or sell it, you know, for free garage slot and some credits? And my answer is, well, we have 74% win ratio in this tank, so it is a victor, you know. It has some pretty good damage ratio and destruction ratio, just average, you know, stats here. I don't like this tank, actually. It is pretty powerful, you know, altogether. But I don't like it because it is still not that much versatile despite decent mobility. I collecting tanks, so I have it in garage, though I wouldn't have it, you know, otherwise. But I would still say a big yes for this tank, you know, with a couple of skills and perks, you know, or more, you can do really big things in this tank, and it is a fun tank, you know, to play. So big yes for this tank. Thank you for watching, and see ya.